Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum friends and subscribers. This is Mahmud Sheikh and in this video I'm gonna discuss how to create a blogging system using PHP MVC Coordinator. This project or this tutorial is a complete package for all the solutions of Coordinator. It includes for most of the commonly asked topics by the viewers. One is register application, how to create a register application, how to create a login application, and how to create a CRUD application, and then how to create a blog system. Okay, so if you see this complete video tutorial, you will be you will get a very good understanding of how to develop these four applications using MVC Coordinator, because I'll be covering all these four topics inside here, inside this tutorial. With this registration, you will come to know how to create a registration application. With this login form, you will come to know how to create a sign-in or login application. And inside this, we have a CRUD application and a blogging system. Let me just give you a glance of this blogging system. Here, subscribers can register from this register form. And subscribers can also log in to this their blogs. The admin will post the blogs and subscribers can view those blogs. Okay, now I will log in as a admin. Okay, now I'm logging in as an admin. So I'll be getting the features like add blog post. Admin can add a blog post. Admin can view, edit, delete, and make changes to the blog. Okay, if I click on add blog post, then admin can type in the title of the blog and then blog description, and he can link a photo for the blog, and once he click on publish post, the blog will get published. Okay, then further, if he want to view that complete blog, he can click on view link and that blog will be displayed. And then if he wants to edit the blog, he can make changes as update. Okay, if he wants to choose post in another image for the blog, then he can do so by clicking on publish post. That blog will get published. Okay, see, updation has been taken care successfully. And now if he wants to delete the blog, he can delete it by just clicking on it. That blog will get deleted from our blogging system. Okay, these are the operations that can be performed by the admin. And if a user or a subscribers get registered, suppose a subscriber registered to our blogging system, like let's say Satish. Okay, will enter his email ID and password, and then let's say okay, let's click on sign up. Okay, now a subscriber has registered successfully, and now if he wants to see the blog that has been posted by the admin, then he can register by entering their email ID and password. He can log into the system with their credentials and he will see the posts that have been published by the admin. Okay, so this is our application. With this application, you will be going to learn how to create a registration application, how to create a login or authentication application, and how to create CRUD application, that is create, read, update, and delete operations, and also how to create a blogging system. Okay, for developing this kind of application, I have used PHP MVC Coordinator and a frame, a CSS HTML framework called Foundation. Okay, so in order to start working on this project, first you need to download Coordinator. I have downloaded a Coordinator package 2.2.6. Coordinator 2.2.6 version I'm using. You can easily get it from the internet. Okay, then once you get this package, you need to copy this and you need to go to your C drive. Inside C drive, go to XAMPP, and inside XAMPP go to HDocs, and then inside HDocs paste your coordinator folder. Give it a name, give it a suitable name, and then paste it here. I have given a name, it as tutorial. And once you have pasted your coordinate folder inside your HDocs folder, then go to your editor and import that folder. Okay, here you can see I have imported the tutorial folder, the tutorial coordinate folder inside my editor. You can do so by just going on File, Open Folder, click on Open Folder, and it will ask you to select the folder from your system. And once you selected the folder, that folder will get start displaying here. Okay, then since I'm working on Foundation Framework also, you need to download this Foundation Framework from internet, going to this URL, foundation.zurb.com/sites/download.html. Then click on this download everything, you will get a rar file like this. Then right click on this and then click on extract here. Okay, once you extract it, you will get two folders, CSS and JS, and one file, index file. Okay, so from now you have what you have to do is you just need to copy these two folders, CSS and JS, and you need to go to your tutorial folder, coordinator folder, open it, and here you need to create a folder with a name called assets or any other name you want to give, like resources. Okay, you need to create a folder with a name called assets. Inside it you need to paste your CSS and JS file. Okay, and make another folder with a name called image. Okay, now once your foundation framework is copied in your project, then you will be left with only this file, index.html file. Then right click and open this file in your editor. Okay, then copy the entire code and come to your project views, view file, welcome message.php. okay, by default whenever you import and import a coordinator project, you will be having three most important folders in your project, namely controllers, models, and views. Views will be having a file, default file, with a name welcome message. When you open this file, you won't get this kind of text because I have already copied the text that I have copied from here. So you just have to, what you have to do, you need to open this file in your editor. Okay, close this. You need to right click, open this file in your editor, then copy the entire content by pressing Ctrl C, and then come to your editor, welcome message, and then Ctrl A, and then paste by pressing Ctrl V. Okay, now press Ctrl S. Okay, then come to your editor and go and type in your project's path 127.0.0.1/tutorial. Okay, see, now since we have copied our index files contained in our coordinator projects, and we are getting this kind of design because it's not loading any CSS and HTML. Here you can see CSS files are referring here. I'm referring here CSS and JS files, but it's not loading here. If I click on right click on and click on inspect, right click and go to view page source. If I click on these links, I will get object not found, because in coordinator the way of referring to files, JSS and CSS files, are different. So let's control Z. Okay, so this is how. You should not refer your files like this directly, okay? You have to refer your files in this way. You need to use base URL. You need to start script, PHP tag, and then echo base URL. Base URL will return you the path till your folder from 127.0.0.1/tutorial till here. Base URL will return you, and from there, after this URL, you need to type in the path. After from that you need to type in the path. Since your JS file is inside your assets folder, so you should start with assets. Okay, similarly you need to do for the CSS files also. Okay, see echo base url assets css foundation.css. okay, now if I go to browser and if I refresh, it will be loading all the CSS and JSS files. And now if I click on right click and click on view pages, page source, see now it's displaying the complete path. If I click on this path, okay, it's loading that JS file, just CSS files. Okay, now close this one. Okay, now you are done with all your setting. Okay, before starting you need to set your database also. So set your database, you need to go to your phpMyAdmin, just type in 127.0.0.1/phpMyAdmin. okay, I have already created a blog database. Click on that blog database. Inside my blog database I have created three tables. One is for storing blog posts, one is for storing the admin and for subscribers, and last one is for storing the roles, TBL user role. I have stored two roles, one is admin and another one is subscribers with ID 1 and 2. And inside my users table I have already stored one record with a name called admin. I have given a name, it has an admin role, user role ID I have given it as 1, which is the role ID of admin. And blog post, okay, I don't have anything in my blog post. Okay, so in order to create a database in phpMyAdmin, you need to type in localhost/phpMyAdmin, then click on database, then click on databases. Okay, if you want to create a new database, then type in your database name here and then click on create. Once you click on create, the database with the given name will be created. And once you have created the database, see it will display it here in a list, and you have to click on the blog on the database name, and here you can create a tables. Then just enter the name of the table and then enter the numbers of fields, how much fields you want in the table, and then click OK. And then you just need to type in the name of the fields, and then automatically your table will get created. Okay, once you are done with all this table creations in your database, then you should go to your editor. Okay, here you need to make some changes in your configuration folder. Inside configuration folder you need to go to your autoload file. Inside autoload file you need to load some of the libraries. Okay, we are working here on form validation libraries, that's why I have used form validation library. Form validation allows you to validate your form. If anyone tries to log in without entering the credential, at that time he should be prompted with suitable messages saying that enter your username and password. Okay, and for that reason we should use form validation library. And since we are dealing with the databases, so we should use database library also. And few more things you need to load is helpers. Helpers also you need to load for helpers like URL helper and form helpers. Okay, so make sure before starting your project you have loaded all these libraries and helpers. And inside you need to go to your database file. Here you need to set your configuration settings of your database. You need to type in hostname as 127.0.0.1 or localhost also you can write, and then username is root. And my data password, I haven't set any password for my database, so I'll just leave it as blank. And then database, my database name is blog. Okay, now save it. Okay, and then you need to go to config file. Okay, in configuration file you need to set encryption key for your session. Let's type in 123. Okay, I have set a encryption key for my sessions. Otherwise if you didn't enter any this session key, then it will show you an error at the time of using sessions in your PHP file. So okay, now we are done with the all these settings or configurations. Now we just need to start typing the code. First we need to design a form. For that we need to type in container. Okay, we need to delete all this content. Okay, delete this. Okay, inside it make one complete row div with a class of row, and inside this row let's create class of small 12, medium 6, large 6 columns. Okay, columns, these are foundation frameworks classes. Okay, enter. Okay, create one more div inside it, class row, and use an h1 blogging system using PHP MVC code igniter. Okay, save it, and then you need to create one more div, copy this, paste it here. Okay, small 12, medium 9, and large also 9. Okay, then h3 sign in, then open a form, open a PHP form, echo form open. Okay, welcome / sign in. Okay, and now you need to close this form, PHP echo form close. Okay, inside this let's create one more div, class row. Okay, and then again copy this code, paste here, and 12, this one is 12 also. Okay, then PHP create one input form, form input. Name equals to email, and then copy, paste here. Okay, then placeholder as email, then copy once again. Class as text box. Okay, now copy, and we need to create a form password. Copy this and paste again, change it to password. Placeholder is password, class is text box. Okay, then again paste this for button submit, form submit name is submit, ओके क्लास देन वैल्यू एज साइन इन एंड क्लास एज हॉलो बटन secondary text box. Okay, this holo button and secondary, all these are classes of foundation framework. Okay, I'll just copy this once again, paste it here. Form, we need a reset button. Reset. Okay, class. Okay, fine. Okay, now let's refresh our page. Okay, our title is displaying here as a blogging system using a PHP MVC code editor, sign in as a title, and two text boxes with two buttons. Okay, now we have to create registration form. We have to create a registration form which will display on the right side. Okay. Okay, press enter and then copy this and paste it here. Okay, 12 columns, 6 columns. Okay, and here is to type in H3 register. Okay, next, create a div with a class of a row okay, and then again copy this, paste it here. Okay, change the class name 12 should be 12. Okay, now create form input, copy this and paste here. Form input name is username, class is textbox, and then paste it here again and change it to form error. Form error helper is for displaying the errors. Form error okay, here you need to pass this name to this, and here need to div of class equals to text danger div. Okay, now we need to copy these two lines, copy and paste it here for email. In placeholder change to email class text box. Okay, then this email name call you should copy to here. Okay, again copy this and change the form field as form to password and make it as password, and placeholder as password, and here you need to copy. Again, once again copy this, paste here and change it to input. Okay, make it as mobile. Okay, and copy this and paste here. Okay, then next we need to copy these two, copy and paste here. We need to create two buttons, one is for register and one is for reset submit. It has sign up. Okay, and okay, this one is same. Okay, now let's run our project. Okay, we also got a registration form on our page. Okay, but I want to display a background image also on this front page. So what I have to do, I have a background image here in my images folder on my desktop. Okay, here I have a BG background image that I have to paste here. Paste here inside my assets. Okay, inside assets make a folder as img, and inside img folder paste that BG or JPG or whatever background image you want. Okay, here to my welcome message.php I have pasted this CSS, some CSS styling. Okay, with the effect of with including by including this CSS file, now I'll be able to see my background image to my front page. Okay, so our front page is completed. Now we need to write some functionality for registering in our welcome controller. Okay, so we need to create a function with the name. Okay, I have not created a form here. Okay, let's copy this and paste it here. Welcome. Test sign up. Okay, and then form close. Delete this. Okay, so now when user click on sign up button, it should redirect it to sign up function inside welcome controller. Okay, now we need to create that welcome. We need to create that sign up function inside welcome controller. Okay, let's copy this and come to our welcome controller and type in public function sign up. And we need to start typing our validation, set validation rules. This form validation set rules. Name is user name. Okay, comma username, and required. Okay, this one is for username, and now copy this and paste four times and make it as email required, password required, and then mobile required. Okay, all these names, username, email, password and mobile fields should be equal to the names which you have given here. This username, email, password, mobile. Okay, these fields must be equal here inside your controller. And then right, if else, if this form validation, okay, copy this, run, then display success or else display validation errors. validation errors. Okay, now here what I'm saying is, if user has entered all the fields values, if user has entered the information in all the field, in all the four text boxes, then it will come to in this block, inside this block, where it will display echo success. If user has not mentioned, or if user has not entered any one of the text box, then it will display validation errors. Okay, now let's check our output, refresh the page. Okay, now if I click on sign up without entering anything in this text boxes, then it's display me the username field is required, email is required, password and mobile, all these fields are required. Okay, so these username, email, password fields are these labels. Okay, and now go back, and if I click on text box 2, say Atul, email as Atul@gmail.com, password Atul, and mobile, and if I click on sign up, it should display me success. Okay, now till now we are going perfectly fine, and now we need to load our model. This load model queries. Okay, we need to create a model inside our model folder with the name called queries. I already created a file with the name called queries. Inside this queries file, I will be writing down my database interaction codes. Okay, for data insertion function, deletion function, updation function, all those database related functions I will going to write in this queries file present inside my model. Now, okay, and $data, I will store the form data inside this data variable, this input post. Okay, and then I will unset the submit form, submit, copy, paste here. Okay, and here I will create a function inside my queries to register public function register. Okay, inside it I will receive the data from the form, and then I will return a value of 0 or 1. Return $this db insert of TBL users and pass this data inside it. Okay, so now I will call this function, copy this, and if else if dollar this queries of, let's paste this, then $this section set flash data with a response as an ID and message as registered successfully. Okay, else paste registration failed. Okay, now we have done a function, now we have created a function to save the user inside our database. This function will return a value of 1 based on the success or failure. If the data gets saved inside the database, then it will return a value of 1. If data didn't get saved in the database, then it will return the value of 0. Suppose the data saved successfully inside the database, then one value gets returned from this function, and here we are checking for that function. If that value 1, if we got a value of 1 from this function, then I will display messages registered successfully, else I will display registration failure. Okay, now inside our database you can see I have already stored a user as an admin. I already stored a user as an admin with a user role ID as 1. You can see here user role ID I have given it 1. So now there is no need for me to store any other person with a user ID of 1. Now I just have to store the subscribers with user ID 2, because in our user roles table we have given user role ID of 2 to our subscribers. Okay, so since we have already stored manually a record for our admin with user role ID 1 inside our users table, now we need to store register subscribers only, not the admin. Okay, so subscribers are having user ID 2, so first we need to, inside our welcome message, we need to set the user role ID of 2 for our subscribers. Okay. Okay, inside this form open using a, okay, here $, okay, PSP, okay, go form return. Okay, we need to create an array here as $data equals to array user role ID of 2. Okay, we are passing user role ID of 2 as a hidden variable. Okay, and this data we are passing inside our form hidden. Okay, so each time when subscribers trying to register, that subscriber should have a user role ID of 2 attached with that form submission, and every time we should get a user role ID of 2 with the subscriber. Okay, so for that reason I have done this. Okay, let's just refresh our page. Okay, now let's check here, right click and click on inspect. Okay, after we can see the role ID is displaying here, user role ID value of 2 which we have assigned to our hidden variable is displaying here. Okay, so now every time when a subscriber tries to register, the user role ID of value 2 will be going along with that form submission and stored inside our database. Okay, so let's try to print the data. Go print, copy this and exit, print R, copy this, paste here. Okay, now let's check, now let's refresh, let's say amir@gmail.com and password. So okay, if I click on sign up, now it's getting me the form data. Okay, user ID 2, username Amir, email amir@gmail.com, password Amir, okay, mobile, and this, now it's, now you can see it's taking form submit value also along with the form data, but we have to remove this form submit value from our data. So we have what we have to do, we just need to okay, we need to cut this and paste here. Okay, now we won't see this form submit value. See, now it's not coming. So for removing that form submit value from our form data, that's why we have used unset data of submit. Okay, now just delete this and let me okay. Refresh on there. Okay. Password. Okay, now let's click on sign up. Okay, let's merge there the okay. Session welcome controller line 22 call to undefined function set flush data. Okay. Okay. We have given an ID here, but we haven't designed an indication or a notification message for this ID. So we have to do it here. Okay, go to our welcome form. Okay, here after form we need to PHP if dollar error or message equals to dollar this. Session flash data, and we need to pass that response ID here inside this PHP and if okay div with the class of response. Okay, and then we need to display here our message. Okay, now save it and refresh the page. Okay, undefined properties here, loader session message 58. This session flash data. Okay, let's go to our config auto load file. We need to copy this paste. We need to call our session library also. And okay, session then session okay then return redirect to our welcome controller. Okay, and here also we need to return this index function. Okay, now let's check. Okay, refresh as I want okay Payal to be as a subscriber .com. Okay, if I click on sign up now, okay, now it's showing me register successful, and if I click on TBL users, Now you can see Payal is inserted in my database with a user ID 2, which is a subscriber. Okay, now we are done with the registration form, and now we should go to work on your login form. Okay, so we need to create a sign in function inside our controller, welcome controller, public function sign in. Okay, same we need to copy this transfer what we have given here, name, email and password. Okay, make it as email. Password. Okay, and now need to set an if condition, else. Okay, same we need to do it here also. Take this, paste it here. In else part I want to load my welcome message. This load view welcome message. Okay, now we need to call our model, copy this, paste it here. Okay, and copy this, paste couple of times for email and password. Okay, these names, this email and password name should be equal to this email and password. So here we are setting, we are taking the values of the form, and we are setting here for set rules, setting the rules for our form. And here by doing this, we are taking the values from the form and we are storing inside this email and password variables. And we need to create a function inside our model to get the records of our admin. Okay, we need to create a function here, public function login. Okay, inside this function we need to pass email comma email and password. Okay, now dollar query equals to dollar this db where. Okay, we need to pass inside an array email field and password field. Copy this here. Okay, and then get need to pass the table name, and we need to check whether we have any record with the specified email and password in our database or not. Dollar copy of num rows is greater than 0. If you are having any record greater than 0, then we will be returning that record. Return dollar query of row. Okay, we'll be returning the row here. Okay, so let's copy this and come to our welcome controller and make an if condition, if else. Okay, if dollar this queries and then paste here. Okay, we are calling this login function which we have just now written inside our model with this function. Okay, here you can see I'm taking the form values, which is email and password, and passing these email and password fields to my function login. And here with this function I'm calling the records. I'm fetching the record of the admin or the subscriber from the database, and once I get the records I'm returning that row from here again to here. Okay, and then based on the response from the database, and I will just cut this out. Okay, I will make a variable as user ID or user equals to paste. Okay, I will return that result to variable called user, and here I will check if that user is having any values, then I will store that user data into session. Store data equals to array. I'll make an array. Okay, I'll path dollar of user ID comma user ID, copy this, paste couple of times, and then username and then email. Okay, then mobile, and then user role ID, okay. So let's first check this. Print R, copy this, paste it here, echo tree, exit. Okay, copy this, paste it here. Okay, now let's check what this function is going to return to us. Refresh and type in. Okay, you know, if I click on sign in, okay, see, you can see now it's returning me the user details of admin: user ID 1, username, my name and email ID, password, user role ID is 1, and then mobile. If I try to log in as Payal, then it will return the credential or details of Payal. Okay, you can see payal@gmail.com. Okay, so all this information is the information which I'm receiving here, I'm storing inside my session. Okay, dollar this session set user data, then inside it I will going to pass this session data inside session. Okay, and then we'll return redirect dashboard, which I have to create now. I need to create a controller with a name called dashboard. Right click on this file, save it with a name called dashboard.php, save it, and copy this, go to dashboard, paste this. Okay, save it, copy this, come here, dashboard echo dashboard. Okay, now let's check. I click on sign in, ओके वेलकम साइन इन ओके इट्स वर्किंग फाइन हियर वी जस्ट नीड टू कॉल द फंक्शन एज डॉलर दिस लोड व्यू एज डैशबोर्ड ओके वी नीड टू क्रिएट अ व्यू हियर क्रिएट अ न्यू फाइल विद द नेम कॉल्ड व्यू एंड echo dashboard save it with a name called dashboard.php okay sign in okay dashboard So I don't sign in. Set user data, session data we have passed, and we need to if inside our else copy welcome. Okay. Dashboard. Dashboard okay fine so this one dashboard okay now let's check refresh okay now we are going into dashboard controller and calling a dashboard view from dashboard controller okay now you can see now we need to create two files one is header file with a name called header save header.php and new file with a name called footer.php okay here and copy this code okay here I have created two files one is header and one is footer and header inside header I have added few lines of code and see this code is exactly same what we have seen here okay and then I have used some styles which I'll be calling in my upcoming sessions in this video tutorial okay bg and for getting these are the css classes which I'll be going to use right now and then I have created a container and this one is for navigation bar okay this one is as this is a header and here is the footer okay now let's just close this I have called this header and footer file inside my dashboard view okay now if I refresh you will see the page exactly like this okay inside this I have a button for logout okay now if I click on type in password and try to login now it's taking me to this page where I have a navigation header and footer okay now let's go to our come to our dashboard view and create a div with a class of row and then div with a class of small medium and large 3 columns okay and then a ul with a class of side name. Okay, and then PHP dollar username equals to dollar this. Session user data. I'm calling the session data. I'm calling the username from my session data which I have stored inside here. Okay, in just few minutes back you had seen I had stored session, all the session data inside my session. So from that session I'm calling the value of username and using inside my dashboard username. Okay, and then li of h3, okay. Class greeting, and here welcome php this username, okay, which I have called from my session. Okay, now let's take one HR and one more LI PHP. Okay, let's just copy this. This here as echo anchor dashboard / add post. Add post comma add blog post. Okay, now this will be our sidebar. And then to create one more view here with the class of copy this here, the class of small 12, 8 and 9. Okay, and your h2 read our blocks. Okay, now let's just refresh our page. See, now I got the name, since I have logged in as an admin and admin name is Mahmood, so it's showing me welcome Mahmood, and it's showing a link also add blog post. This should come inside this. Now refresh. Okay, now we need to create a post. So let's just refresh. Okay, when I click on add blog post, it should go to dashboard add post. Okay, so we need to create a function with a name add post inside our dashboard. So let's go to our dashboard controller, and here we need to create as public function add post. Okay, and here dollar user id equals to dollar this session user data. Here I'm calling the user id from my session and checking if dollar not for not user ID if the person who is clicking this link is not an admin, then I'll just return it to my welcome term redirect welcome controller. Okay. Else, if the person who is clicking on this ad blog post is actually an admin, then I will take that person to my view. This load view of ad post. Okay, now we need to create a view with a name called ad post. Copy this and go up to views. Click on file. Okay, just save it with a name ad post dot php. Okay, copy this. Just share. Okay, now inside this we need to create an ad post form. Okay, we need to come here, just to copy this entire code, go to add post and paste here. Here we need to change it as add new post. Okay, now let's check. Now if I click on this add blog post, now I will get a different function inside dashboard add post. Now we need to create a form here. Okay, you can see I have created a form here, add new post, and I have used a row. Inside that row I have created another div with a class of these, and I have opened a form open multipart method. Okay, form open multipart helper, and inside that I have passed a function as publish post, which is present inside my dashboard. So I have to create a publish post function inside my dashboard. Here, public function publish post. Okay, so whenever user click on the on publish post button, function inside the controller dashboard publish post will get executed. Okay. Here you can see I have used echo form open multipart my form helper, because with this I'll be posting two types of data. One is text and another one is image. For that reason I have used form open multipart. And then you need to create a form input text the way we had created for while working with our registration form. You need to exactly do the same thing for here, and then you need to create a text area for description and error also, and for upload error also. And then last is a submit button. Okay, once you create this form, you need to go to your project and refresh. You will see a form add blog post with a form is displaying here. Okay, now if I click on back, okay, if I click on add blog post, now it's taking me to the form where I have a form with title, description and a button for loading the for choosing the image. And then if I click on publish post, that image will get saved inside my database. And now we need to write the function for publishing this post inside our controller dashboard. But once you are done with your add post form, we need to create a publish post function inside our dashboard. Okay, so we have to go to our dashboard controller, and here you can see I have written down the code for publish post. I have made a separate video tutorial or separate movie on this topic, how to upload an image to server using PHP Codeigniter. You can refer that tutorial also. Here I have there at the time of making that video of how to upload an image to server, I have used exactly the same code where what I have written here. So explanation, I have completely explained the entire code in my last video, which I have already uploaded, and the title of that uploaded video is how to upload an image to server using PHP coordinator. Okay, here you can see I have created a config variable, config array. Inside that I have set a upload path as uploads and allow types of different types that I want to allow. And here you need to create a folder with a name called uploads in your root directory. Here you just need to right click and click on new folder and make a folder as uploads. Okay, once you create a folder, you need to load an upload library and then set the rules for your title and description. This title and description should be same whatever names you have given here, post title and post description. Okay, then we need to check if form validation runs and if this upload do upload, and then we need to store the data inside this data variable, form data. We need to store inside the data and then upload data, and each and every line of piece of code I have explained in that previous movie. It's better for you guys to watch that movie also. Okay, now if I click on save and go to my browser, and if I refresh, okay, write the title blog one. Okay, blog one description, and choose the file. It's this, and if I click on publish post, okay, here I have not created insert post function inside my queries, which we have to create it right now. Okay, here now on my queries I have pasted, or I have written the code for inserting the post inside our database. So this, what this function will do is, okay, so we are here. Okay, here you can see I have used a function called insert post. From here this function will call, which is present inside our data, inside our queries. This function call and will receive the data, which is whatever data has been entered inside the form. The data will come here, and with the help of this statement, this db insert, all the data will be inserted inside the table called as tbl post, and it will return a value of 1. Once that, if the data gets stored inside the database, then it will return the value of 1. If not, then it will return the value of 0. Suppose if the data gets stored inside the database and it has returned the value of 1 to here, then here it will check if the return value is 1, then it will, if the return value is not 1, then it will return post. If the return value is 1, then it will return the message as post published successfully. If the return value from this function is 0, then it will return the failed to publish post. Okay, then in both the cases I will redirect to dashboard controller, and then if user has not filled any data inside the form fields, then I will redirect it to them to add post again. Okay, now let's refresh again. And blog one, then blog one description, and choose an image. See, okay, now if I click on publish post, now let's see whether we get a post in our database or not. Okay, this one is users. Okay, we should go to tbl posts. Okay, here you can see I have got a post which I have just uploaded or just posted from my portal. And if I come here and if I check upload, you can see an image is also saved inside my uploads folder. Okay, now we have missed something. Okay, we need to go to dashboard view, and above this we need to copy this and come here to dashboard view and paste it here. Okay, now let's go back and click on add post blog post again and type in blog 2 and type blog 2 description. Choose an image as this one and click on publish post. Now you'll get a message saying that post published successfully. Okay, now I have to display all the posts that I have published inside this home page. Okay, if I click on home page blog system, I should be display all the posts that I have uploaded to my server. So to do that, we need to go to our dashboard view. Here we need to display all those posts. Okay, here I have all the code written. Previously we had written till here, and now I have already written the code that is used to fetch the records from the database. Okay, so we need to come here, we need to take this variable and go to controller. Okay, and we need to call this load model queries is $ records. Okay, $ records of $ this queries of we need to call the function which is here. This function is used for fetching the record from fetching the post from the database. Okay, and we need to copy and pass this to our copy. Okay, now let's remove this. Okay, now what we have done is we have in our dashboard index function we have load our queries, and with the help of queries we have loaded the get post function which we have written inside our model function. And this function fetches the complete posts from our database and return us here inside our controller. Okay, all the posts will be stored inside this variable, and then we are passing this as an array to our dashboard view. And here in our dashboard view we are receiving that we are checking whether this variable holds any data or not. If this variable holds any data, then we will be for loop, we will be looping through that entire result set using for each loop, and then we are displaying the records post image and post title and then post description. Okay, and we have and to that each post we have link the view option and edit option and delete option. Okay, let's just refresh our page. Okay, now you can see I am successfully able to fetch all my posts from my database. Okay, now if I click on this view, it's taking me to the method called as post. Okay, post with an ID. Let me just create this function post, edit post and delete post. Okay, let's go to here inside our controller, function post, and then edit post. Copy edit post and then delete post. Delete post, okay. Now let's refresh. And now if I click on view, it's taking me to dashboard post with an ID of 2. And if I click on edit post, it's taking me to dashboard of edit post of ID 2. And if I click on delete post, it's taking me to delete post of ID 2. Okay, now we need to achieve this CRUD functionality of updating, deleting and viewing the single post. Now let's go here. We need to create one view file with a name called as post. Save it with a name called as post.php. Okay, inside this post we need to we need to copy this entire code, copy and paste it here. Okay, I have written down the code for post, for displaying the single post. See, I have make a row and I have stored the user ID in a, I have fetched the user ID from my session and then username from my session based on that, and then I have display with the welcome message and the name of the username, and then there will be a, this is the sidebar and this section is for displaying the post. Okay, now go to our add dashboard view or dashboard controller. Here we need to call our view, load view. Okay, and here we need to call a model, color this load model as queries, and then dollar post equals to, we need to make a function inside our queries, inside our model, to fetch the selected row or to fetch the selected post. Dollar this queries of get single post. Okay, here we need to receive the post ID and the same copy and paste here. Okay, here, so when we refresh here, when a user clicks on that view, an ID will be passed with this link. Let's me show you. If I click on the view, okay, now see, you can see ID has been passed here. ID is passed with a value of 2. Okay, if I want to get this value, echo your post ID, okay, and just let's see. Okay, now you can see 2 is returning, which is the post ID. If I click on this, 1 is returning, which is the post ID. Okay, now this post ID we need to pass to our model. Okay, model where is single get single post ID. Copy this and paste here, and we need to pass this to our post view. Copy, paste, save it. Okay, and we need to create this get single post function inside our model, which we have I have already created. See, to this I had passed post ID, and with the help of this post ID I am fetching the records from the database. In where clause I have passed this post ID, and this function return me the post, single post. Refresh, I click on view, see. Okay, undefined variable post. Okay, post view 16. Okay, here it's posts, so we need to change it to copy this post. Okay, refresh. Okay, posts. Edit. Okay, now I'm getting the post, single post. Okay, so this is how you can get a single post from the database. Okay, I will stop here guys, I'm running short of time. In my next video in this series I will try to cover how to edit a post, how to delete a post, and how to log out, and how to how a subscriber can log in, and what happens when subscriber log in, what should be displayed to the subscriber. Okay, so when an admin log in, admin will be able to see this information of adding a blog post, leaving a blog post, editing, deleting, and adding a blog post. But what happens when a subscriber gets login? He should be displayed with different information, right? So that we will be going to achieve in my next video. Okay, so don't go anywhere guys, we will see you in my next video, where we'll be discussing the rest of the functionality of this blogging system. And if you like this video tutorial, subscribe to my channel and click on like button and share it with your friends, and I will see you guys in my next video. Thanks for watching.